more important is Sujata Pandey. Today, TMC is also arguing, and there are in fact very disturbing images where they have lost four of their cadre. So they are saying, yes, it's an unfortunate legacy that West Bengal has, but violence is being perpetrated by both sides. So Padmaja, don't sit in judgment.
While we are sitting and discussing who's done what and whose cadre has died, you know, I want to put one point very clear. I think we all will be agreeing to that. In the core of all the violence that we are seeing today, is the long-rooted problem of normalizing violence in West Bengal during pre- and post-elections. Am I audible?
Yes, Padmaja, please go on.
Am I audible? Yes. So, I'm surprised, yes, that even the left Luthian right activists, the senior politicians, the Rahul Gandhi, who was just few months ago was claiming that democracy in India is dead and we are a partial free country, is lauding Mamata Banerjee when his own cadres are being vandalized and their houses have been broken. It's a shame. It's a shame for the democracy, yeah, our federal structure and the fundamental right to live and have a ideological difference. On top of it, Mamata Banerjee, being a woman herself, and she's been peddling this that she's the Bengal ki beti, and she has been doing nothing but whitewashing the entire claim.
Perhaps the saddest outcome of this entire episode has been, think of the Congress karyakarta at this point, from top to bottom, in all other parties who claim they are being targeted by the TMC. The leadership at least is standing by them. They are taking their word. But in the Congress, while the state leadership is saying that our karyakartas are being brutalized, at the center, you still have some leaders who think this is a victory for democracy and the idea of India. Yes, a victory for democracy maybe, but the idea of India, I will leave that to your wisdom.